Here it is. Miłosz Rodzinski will start off with the serve.
Love one.
Ooh, chop block attempted out here.
One off.
Darko Jorgic not known for this shot, but of course at this level, players can do just about anything imaginable in the game. Good pressure from Kubik with the
one,
backhand.
Two
right-handed players on both sides. Second time we've seen that today in this session. The start and
three,
finish
one.
Of the session. Polish pair with the 3-1 lead. Nice change of pace in the block from behind the table, Tomislav Putar. If you're newer just tuning in doubles, you must alternate shots, which makes it tricky for players using the same hand to share the space. Right-handed, left-handed combination. That's the preferred way. It just makes it a little bit more convenient to get out of the way, share the space. Play four hands from the middle of the table. Not only that, the serve must be from the right side on the diagonal, only in doubles. Nice combination, backhand to put it away with Putsad. Jorgic with the opening spin on the parallel, doesn't try to kill it. The follow-up from Putsad. Extra spin comes in, and you can hear the effort it takes to try and control it, keep it down. Ooh, good receive for a long serve, a little bit off the net there. But when it comes in fast and long, a player who was determined to play it with his backhand still manages to take the point. Beautiful forehand flick, a little net on that one as well. It levels the playing field at 6 points apiece. Long serve and not fooled. Putsar takes a quick turn. It seemed that he hadn't predetermined to play a backhand, just stayed loose and ready. Oh, what a save, Kubik from right behind Rodzinski. Not an easy place to be stuck. Watch where Rodzinski gets pinned here. And still Kubik drives it past on the parallel to tie it up. Times for a man with such a backhand. Darko Jorgic hasn't been able to quite cause the pain on the other side with that backhand yet. Good control by the Polish pair. And full explosion here. Turns and extends. Lunges forward as he steps around for this forehand rip side topspin. Catching Putsar with the racket up. It's two game points now for the younger Polish pair. It's a good long push. Quite surprising Kubik there. And the forehand from the baseline. Kubik puts it away. So Rodzinski and Kubik take game number one. Darko Jorgic serving to Miłosz Rodzinski.
Love one.
The surprise factor, even in their push game. Look at this young Polish pair. Not everything has to be an attack. They're showing incredible maturity. 7 of the last 8 points they've won. No, a run by backhand. Out of position, full extension, still causes the pressure. This is a really crazy shot. Fast backhand, Jorgic in the middle. It was Koki Niwa-like, Yukiya Uda-like. I think you table tennis hardcore fans know what I'm talking about. I'm just shocked right now because some of the greatest weapons from the mixed pairing of Puzarra and Jorgic right now is just coming back every time. But a good kick serve here from Puzarra. Deeper on the table, with a side and topspin. There it is, right to that baseline. String of points here to tie things up. Oh, nice move on this, taking advantage, moving in quickly. Puzarra with the blitz. Short rallies here again. The mixed pairing looking to get the point over with where they can. For an understandable reason, because if they keep the ball in play, the young Polish pair have been able to attack from both wings very quickly. Controlling in the short game, Kubik and Rodzinski. And again on the receive here, nothing has been comfortable. I think tournament players out there know what it's like when none of your serves bother the receiver. From time to time they do. Oh man, the save. Rodzinski had to dodge the corner of the table just to get back in cover. Should it come down one more time? Check it out, that shot was impressive. And then Kubik falling, feet tangled, still managed to make the winner. Aussie, Aussie, Aussie. Oi, oi, oi. You heard the second part of that out here. Jorgic trying to keep that wrist loose for the backhand that we've seen over the years. Caused some problems. We'll break off the net here from Puzarra on the move. Into that big middle, the target is the elbow. Puzarra, the tallest player on court. The Polish pair with three game points. Soft hands, Rodzinski taking responsibility though. Didn't think it was a bad receive. He obviously knows he could have done a bit better to put his partner in a position to win the point or to make Puzarra think a little bit more to figure out how to respond. There it is, backhand down the line. Kubik puts it away. So Miłosz Rodzinski to start it off with the serves. 2-0 lead for the Polish pair. And a nice fade on this one. A bit of inside out spin with that forehand. Finally, something that causes some trouble. A good move. I mean, it was 11-8 in both games, so just feels a bit more one-sided than it has been. Bit off the net here, Puzarra committing to the backhand spin. Such perfect placement here, Rodzinski going deep cross court. It takes such not only peripheral vision, but awareness of where the opponent is standing and where their partner is. Anything you can do to get them to cluster up, create a little bit of an obstacle. Beautiful backhand inside the table as Putsar sets up a 2-point lead at the first towel break. It's been a long time coming. The threat with the receive game. Humidity yesterday, I think, was 87% in the city. Stadium doing everything to make it as easy to play in as possible. Oh, quick down the line. Kubik, too quick. Timeout called. Alongside Ugo Calderano and Yuen Jianan. Bit of frustration here as timeout hasn't been cashed in just yet. First point out of it to the opponents. So complete in this game. The Polish pair in their touch game, their attack game. Indecision can be a killer in life. Out here, there's little of it for the Polish pair. But a good response on this. Just another good example. Short stroke. Racket high, Putsar just lifting up to add some topspin.
6-6.
So a few now out of the timeout into the towel break. Putsar and Jorgic fighting to extend this match. Again off the top of the net.
Seven.
Talked about decision making. The Polish pair with such clear intention so early in the point. Been a little bit of improvising shorter strokes on the other side. Good variation in the serve. Heavy push, and Darko Jorgic's backhand has been a weapon that hasn't really come out to its full, I don't know, full threat, let's say. It's been shut down. With the forehand as well from the back of the table. Again, people often wonder how tall these players are. Darko Jorgic, maybe it's the power of his backhand or how low he stands when he plays, but he's a much bigger guy than you'd realize. For the first time this match, the backhand has really caught the attention it deserves. It's powerful, and even from behind the table, watch him move. Ah, there it is. Such little backswing and so much forward power. Again, a bit of cryptic signaling, how they communicate to each other to keep their secrets. Taking the chance from behind the table, Kubik. And it's now a game point. Just one game point for Putsar and Jorgic to cash in this timeout. Ooh, the serve felt so handcuffing, yet somehow the Polish pair were able to keep themselves in the point from the defense at the baseline. Now, deuce, alternating serves until one pair has a 2-point lead. Had he hit the ball, Christian Carlson did this, and it makes it. It doesn't matter. Looks cool, doesn't count. Must be in control of the hand. What a response. Radzymski with the drive-by backhand once again. Running through the court, keeps it in play with quality nonetheless. Wilson a lob, It's a counter. Second deuce. Smart play with Jorgic behind the table. Says, I don't need to drive it deep. I'm going to spin it. Slow it down. Let me arc it securely on the table. Nice timing. Smart play. Good placement. Everything right. And it sets up match point. Still in it. Putsad and Jorgic at the fourth towel break. Backhand opening to the baseline. See a bit of discomfort there. Putsar puts it into the elbow. Creates an uncomfortable forehand counter. And the long, relatively empty push. Rajimski and Kubik with one more match point. There it is. Backhand sneaks it past. Edge of the racket doesn't matter. 3-0, the bagel here.